Sup, the gods?
Same Battlefield T. Got a pretty good thing for you to have a quick listen to. This was recorded. This was probably one of the first ones that I'd done, which is it's pretty insane because, the reality of it is. I wasn't lying in the in the last line, but you'll see what I mean. This was about circa 2012, I'd say, and I'd just smoked my first joint in a long time. So, yeah, and I mean 3 years. Actually, to put it even more in context, I had broken a three literally on my so it was November 5th, and I had been sober, fully everything sober, including like I wasn't Cali sober basically, for 3 years at this point. And my boss at the time was looking to spark a joint, and she was doing this, that was right, she was like, and I just went, give me that. And didn't even think about it, and before I knew it, bang, there I was, stoned. Not obviously straight away, but I realised kind of immediately what I'd done. I'd broken this 3 year sobriety, but then on top of that, I was like, oh, well, if I've done that, I might as well keep going.
Yeah, so productive production.
Oh, yeah, and also, this is transformative in nature, and also a review. So not only is it transformative, but I'm reviewing the transformation, the transformative nature of this song. So it's like a double... copyright layer of protection.
This is a flow, yo. MAZIRE. Bringing in the effects. Yeah. Mary Jane, I got a lot to say. We've been together since back in the day, and you played with my mind so much that I had to say that we must part ways, cause I'm going insane. I'm going insane. I'm going insane. And then I went insane, training every day about to fight MMA.
See, that's true. So I did go insane. You know, I was off the Mary Jane for a long time, and then because of that, I needed some other outlet, and MMA became my outlet. And so I trained virtually every single day. And at this point in time, I was literally, actually, that's another thing. I was like 2 weeks away from, so I'm getting stoned for the first time in, like, was actually longer. I hadn't been smoking weed up until I went sober. I was actually drinking a lot more. But I went sober. And you know, so I hadn't had any drugs or drink or anything for like 3 years, and then I have this spliff that I ended up, you know, getting stoned that night, and it was like 2 weeks before my MMA fight.
Changed my path after the aftermath of the past of my,
which I won, check out my channel.
After my eyes and laugh when I look at where I am from where I've been, it's a dream. I never believed this speed fiend would be so keen, determined with a big D.
Let's analyze that because it's awesome. Looking at where I am from where I've been, it's a dream. I never believed that this speed fiend would be so keen, determined with a big D. Double entendres.
Kick the bone to the curb, not just give us his herb. Work, never shirk, cause the perks go to the perps.
Work, never shirk, cause the perks go to the perps. Man, I, Like, I had some fucking... I had some rhymes back then.
I'm a winner who was once a sinner and a grinner when I think of the times. So drink it, send me blind, take chunks of time and leave me nothing to remember them by.
I'm a sinner who was once a grinner. I'm a sinner who was once a winner and a grinner when I think of the times the drink had send me blind, take chunks of time and leave me nothing to remember them by.
Bye-bye. Be clear of the beer for more than 3 years.
Oh no. I'm going to download this. So steer clear from the beer for more than 3 years. I'll just pull this up.
I'm going insane and then I went insane. Train and a grinner when I think of the times. So drink it, send me blind, take chunks of time and leave me nothing to remember them by. Bye bye. Steer clear of the beer for more than 3 years. When I storm nations, watch your ears, hear, hear.
When I storm nations, watch your ears, hear, hear.
It's a mere beginning of an amazing creation. My current occupation ain't fake, and I'm making hay while the sun shines. And when it's go time, I begin on the mic, reminiscing on the list of missing, missing, just missing, prison, listening to rhythms.
That's fucking great. Hang on.
Sun shines, and when it's go.
I'm making hay while the sun shines, and when it's go time.
I begin on the mic
reminiscing on the list of mischief missions.
Reminiscing on the list of missing, just missing prison. Listening to rhythms writing rhymes.
Reciting the Y in the place of the crime of getting high.
With a joint by my side and a smile on my dial. It's been a while since I felt the mild beguiles.
It's been a while since I've felt the mild beguiles. So the mild beguiles.
Of the world's greatest gift, the spliff. Don't get it twisted, I'm a former meth head who should be dead.
That's true.
But the real threat isn't to be found in a shed on stems. To what end?
That's also true.
Is weed evil? Come on, people. You can't say you're free when a plant is illegal. Goddamn, goddle damn the man that didn't stand against the government's plan to ban thought. Keep you thinking if you get caught, they're gonna slam you in court. It's a rot. The only reason we should be believing our leaders aren't even is if they're dying and you're seeing them bleeding.
The only reason we should be believing our leaders aren't thieving is when they're dying and you're seeing them bleeding. If they're not, they're lying, is the next line.
If they're not, they're lying.
So basically what I've just said there is, don't believe your leaders, because unless you can actually see them dying, they're not actually dying. They're lying.
So don't be blind to the writing on the wall. Be appalled and maybe they'll wage war on the situation of the poor. Is discipline really something to be instilling within a regime dedicated to killing more innocents and insurgents?
Is discipline really something to be instilling? Is discipline...
Blind. So don't be blind to the writing on the wall. Be appalled and maybe they'll wage war on the situation of the poor. Is discipline really something to be instilling within a regime?
Is discipline really something to be instilling within a regime dedicated to killing more innocents than insurgents?
Dedicated to killing more innocents than insurgents. Straight murder.
So that rhyme scheme change, like, it doesn't work, and then it fucking does. Like, look, I'm going to say it. I'm a genius.
I'm sure you've heard of burn the midnight wax since I've turned my life astern. It's a fact, my rats attract when I lay down track. It's like every whack cat has my back. And all my girls and bros know that when I throw the gauntlet, motherfuckers better respect.
I want to just say that whack cat line. I used that in a couple of my rhymes when I was younger. And it was kind of something that I said. I still say, hey, he's a whack cat, or he's a different kind of cat. Like, I use that all the time. But there's a certain really high profile Australian rapper that ended up ripping that, and I'm not going to say who, but if you've heard the line, you'll know where it's from.
I never regret because I learn. I never neglect in case I get burned. In place is a strategy, systematically attacking the alphabet mathematically. I've got the real hip-hop, you know it as soon as it drops. I've got a flow that can't be stopped, and I'm recording this within earshot of a cop.
Fuck! So again, there's that, as I said, that last line was actually true, that I was within earshot of a cop. Anyway, that was the song's name, Earshot of a Cop.